Very good afternoon to all. On behalf of Dr. B.C. Rai Polytechnic College, I, Sumanto Das, lecturer of Department of Electronics and Telecommunication Engineering, welcome you all in the theme-based webinar series on transformative reforms under New Education Policy 2020. So first of all, I would like to thank Mr. Tarun Bhattacharya, General Secretary of DCRC Society, Professor Dr. Chandan Kumar Ghosh, Principal Dr. B.C. Rai Polytechnic, for encouraging us to conduct this webinar. I would also like to thank Professor Dr. Sukalpa De, HOD of Basic Science and Humanities, Mr. Pijush Kanti Ghosh, HOD of Computer Science and Technology Department and Nodal Officer, to give me an opportunity to coordinate today's webinar. Today's webinar is the seventh day of conducting such webinar series, and today's theme is Research, Innovation, and Ranking. To enlighten us with this topic, I would like to welcome today's keynote speaker, Professor Dr. Nirmal Kumar Roy, Professor Head in the Department of Electrical Engineering of National Institute of Technology, Durgapur. He did his PhD in Electrical Engineering from University of South Australia in year 2000 in the field of High Voltage Engineering. He did his Master's in Electrical Engineering from Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore in year 1987, Bachelor in Electrical Engineering, National Institute of Technology, Durgapur in the year of 1985. He is having his academic experience more than 16 years in Department of Electrical Engineering, National Institute of Technology, Durgapur, 2 years in College of Military Engineering, Pune, Ministry of Defense, Government of India, and research scholar at University of South Australia, Australia. He has industrial experience of almost more than 12 years in National Test House Kolkata as Assistant Director, National Test House Kolkata and Ghaziabad, Assistant Engineer in Tata Electric Company, Mumbai, Hindustan Aeronautics Limited, Bangalore. His research interest lies in high voltage engineering and high voltage testing and evaluation, online monitoring with laser and optical technique, magnetic fields near power lines and human environment for possible biological effects, e-governance, information communication technology, and Internet of Things. He is presently engaged in development of ICT and IoT-enabled high-voltage laboratory facilities at NIT Durgapur. He is having around 70 publications in international and national journals and conferences. He is associated with several projects from different ministries like Ministry of Human Resource Development, Ministry of Electronics and Information Technology, and Ministry of Power and Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. He has designed and developed several laboratories like High Voltage Laboratory in National Test House, Ghaziabad, under Ministry of Commerce, Government of India, High Voltage Laboratory in College of Military Engineering, Ministry of Defense, Pune, ICT-enabled High Voltage Laboratory, Power Audit and Insulation Lab at National Institute of Technology, Durgapur. He has developed several learning resources such as computer-based training material on diesel power plants, computer-based training material on high-voltage virtual laboratory, computer-based learning material for energy systems. His international visits include Australia, Singapore, France, Thailand, Oman, Germany, and Switzerland for several government assignments till date. He has been recognized as Technology Angel in year 2007 by Department of Science and Technology, Government of India. He is a National Overseas Scholarship Holder in 1994. He is a Delphi expert recognized by Indian Institute of Planning, Delhi and IIT Delhi, year 2009. He has been chaired many national and international events in our country as well as in abroad. So this is a brief introduction to our resource persons of today's webinar. Now I would like to hand over this session to Professor Dr. Nirmal Kumar Roy to enlighten us on today's topic. Over to you, sir.
Okay. Am I audible now?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yes. Thanks, Sumanta, and that very long. I didn't want that very long. Basically, this introduction, you took at almost that 5 minutes. Okay. So thank you first that patron to giving me the chance and opportunity for talking in this auspicious event, basically very hot event now, that is National Education Policy in 2020. And I also thank Dr. Chandan Ghosh, that the principal and chair, and convener nodal officer, Mr. Piyush Kanti Ghosh, and Mr. Sumanta Das, that this coordinator basically, and overall that Madam that Shukalpo De, who basically organized or invited me through that, and my beloved students and ladies and gentlemen. So I will talk regarding this research, innovation, and the ranking. So I'll switch over to my presentation. Is it now visible?
Yes, sir, visible, sir, visible.
So before basically starting my presentation, I want to tell something regarding why that I am choosing this. This is a very challenging job for me, and I took that challenge. And this is regarding that national education policy, which involves research, innovation, and funding, basically, not ranking. But the lot of seminars and talks have been happened last 1 year regarding research, innovation, and funding. And here we have given the topic that research, innovation, and ranking in NEP 2020. Why I'm telling that's a challenge, because we are facing different type of challenges in our education system, and what are the challenges that are not clear basically for us. Now I will highlight in my presentation that what are the challenges now we are facing in education system, and how this national education policy can be to 2020 that will be addressed by all these challenges. So better that we should know about that challenges. So that way I have made that presentation. It is little bit different from that natural, that what research, what innovation. A lot of people are talking about that research, innovation, and also funding, how it can happen. That if you go to that web resources, you can get a lot of material there. But nobody basically talks about that, why this National Education Policy 2020 is required after that 34 years. Around that, after 34 years, we are changing our National Education Policy. So why we are changing this, that we should know. So I'll address this topic in my that talk. Basically, what are the challenges we are facing, that what are the key challenges basically in new era, this our new generation, they are growing very fast and they are very smart. That you should also appreciate, that they are very smart and they are growing very fast basically. And the transformation in education also, we have to go to the same space, basically same pace you have to go, otherwise we'll be lagging. So that's why that this NEP 2020 has come. And I hope that all, not all the challenges, some of the challenges basically that addressed by this NEP 2020. And I will talk about little bit that how to do that research and that innovation part, that how you can conduct that research and innovation, that I will talk. And one more very important thing I will talk here, that due to this very fast that changes are happening, So it is basically creating a lot of disruption in different sectors. Not only that in marketing, not only that in media, not only that this grocery market like that. I will talk these things in my presentation. And at last, I will talk about that ranking. Why that ranking question has come? That also I will talk this ranking and rewarding. So I have added one more word here that is rewarding basically. So monitoring of institutes through ranking and rewarding. That is very important in my that view. That is very important. And in a lot of forum also have discussed in ministry as well as in Delhi, I have discussed this thing that ranking and this rewarding business will be there. Okay. And then we'll conclude our that discussion. And what are the challenges basically? That challenge one, I have given that challenge one is changing that global economy.
Sir, yes. Sorry to interrupt you, but your slides are freezed.
This now is all right?
No, sir, still it is freezed.
Fixed?
Yes, sir, still fixed now, sir. It is not advancing.
Okay, then I will go to again this front. Okay, maybe.
Yes, sir, now I can see. Yes, sir, it's content.
That not this slide mode. This is not slide mode, basically.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I have to go to slide mode. Okay, 1 minute. Give me 1 minute. I think I can solve this problem.
Okay, sir.
Is it visible now?
No, yes. Sir. I think you have not presented the screen, sir.
Oh, yeah. That's right. I have to go to the presenting mode. Yes, I think it will be sorted out. Is it all right now?
No, sir. Not visible. Yes, sir.
Yes, yes, sir. Yes, come.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yeah, I can see it. Okay, sir.
Now it's all right, huh?
Yes, sir. All right.
Okay. So I was talking about that what are the challenges now, these key challenges in new era, and how basically that we'll cope up with this by addressing with that NEP 2020. And I will also talk about the concept of research and innovation. And research and innovation basically creates disruption. I have already talked with that. And monitoring of institutes and ranking and rewarding also very much important. Okay, that I have already discussed this thing. So next slide, I'll switch over this next slide. Is it now gone? Slide changed?
Yes, sir, it has changed.
Changed, yes. Okay, you, Sumanto, you just tell yes, me okay, if anything wrong.
Sure, okay. Sir.
Okay. So now, what are the challenges in new era? That challenge one is changing that global economy. What is that basically? If I talk about that changing of global economy, what is that global economy? That is very interesting. So earlier, say 20 years back, if you see, then China was almost that 1/10 of economy of US. But in 2019 data, it is telling that almost 2/3 of that US economy that China has been achieved. So what is happening basically now, this economy is not fixed in one or in developed country like that, in US, Europe like that. It is now changing very fast. Very fast it is changing. And we are expecting that this India will go to a third position and just keeping behind Germany will be keeping behind, and Japan also will be keeping behind. Will be after US, basically. China will be top, then US will be there. In the third position in 2030, we may be that in third position. That is the prediction, basically. So that way that the global economy is changing and globalization. Now, another topic, this is globalization. What is globalization, basically? Globalization is basically happening that if you think, say 20 years back or 1991, that time that real that globalization was happening during the regime of our finance minister, that Dr. Manmohan Singh, he had made in 1991, when he was very that shortage of our that foreign currency, then we have sold our gold like that. That time it has been started. Now slowly that globalization is taking shape, and we can tell that now world is flat almost. Okay, that if anything is happening in one corner, that immediately that is coming to that in a developing country as well as that underdeveloped countries. Another challenge is that demographics. Okay, what is that demographical? That is, so in Europe or the developed countries, we are seeing that lot of the aged people. Okay, so if aged people are there, the nation development, that hope is slowly that decaying basically. Not that it is increasing, but if you see that in Southeast Asia, especially in India and Pakistan and Bangladesh, this region, you can see that a lot of young people. So around that in India, that 650 million people are in under 30. Okay, so this is a great advantage in demography advantage. This also another challenge, no, not only advantage, this is also a challenge, because these people are growing, so you have to create jobs for them. Okay, you have to create skills for them. Otherwise, they will be unemployed and a lot of problem will be coming. So this demographical also one challenge now. And the fourth one is that technological change. This technological change, what is the technology basically? That for developing anything, we are creating new thing and we are using that technology for creating that thing. And that changes are happening very fast. Okay, that changes are happening very fast. So this technological change also a challenge. Why is it a challenge? Because that say one example I am giving, that Redmi Note 8. Okay, so 6 months or say for that 10 months back, that Redmi Note 8 was that's the ideal one that time. It's the hot one that time. But now that Redmi 10 Pro. So within 6 months or 8 months, this is changing. So this is the technological change. So how to cope up with this technological change? That is also a challenge. And technological innovation. And technological innovation means due to these changes, lot of innovations are happening and it is also very fast. So how to cope up with these all challenges that are have to address? And I hope that this NEP 2020, that will be addressed all these challenges, not that in all points, but some points will be challenges by this NEP 2020. So first is that challenge one, the knowledge economy. Okay, so what is that knowledge economy? One thing that I can remember that Bill Gates, okay, Microsoft, that CEO, Bill Gates. So he told once 20 years back, I used to tell in almost all the presentation that the society is changing to the knowledge-based society. Okay, now who will be having the knowledge? He will be king, basically. So the knowledge economy, that's why the challenge is knowledge economy. One example, that one first point you can see, that product to ideas. One is that product to ideas means earlier there was value in the products and that products last for say 5 years, 10 years like that. But now these products are no more the king. Now ideas. Okay, if you have good ideas, then you are the king in 21st century. So 20th century, if you take, then that products, you are the king, but now the ideas are the king. Okay. Another thing, that manufacturing to services. That manufacturing to services, if you compare that in our GDP, then 18 to 20% for manufacturing center sector. But in service sector, it is 60 to 65% like that. It varies. Okay, in different years, it varies. So that manufacturing is not a prime motto for that any country now. That the services are getting the diverse seat now for any GDP driving seat. Okay, so this manufacturing to services, then public policy to markets. Okay, public policy means that earlier the government used to give the guidelines. Okay, this you do, this you do. Okay, now also it is there. We are not forgetting, but in some sector that markets are deciding basically in 21st century that markets will decide the policy, public policy. Okay, what will be the public policy? That will be decided by the market. And next is that monopoly to innovation. Okay, earlier there was monopoly. So I can give one example, then you can understand that monopoly to that innovation. This is a very important one. That monopoly to innovation, earlier, if you want to buy a Bajaj scooter, okay, I'm giving example, say 30 years back, if you want to buy a Bajaj scooter, okay, or I'll go to that BSNL also, then if you want to have a phone line that time, then you have to be a doctor, either you have to be a doctor or you have to some IAS officer, IPS officer, okay, or some bureaucrat like that. Okay, then you will get that line fast. Okay, so BSNL was the only player or telecom player in India. Okay, so on their wish, basically, you will get that line. Similar, that Bajaj scooter, you have to book that scooter. After 2 years or 3 years, your line will come. Then you can get this scooter. So that monopoly is no more now. Okay, now that monopoly has gone. And this innovation has come. So what is the result for that? Result is that lot of that this know-how and skill things are now happening. Okay. And knowledge economy is also growing. Okay. And now there are the importance of the iron and oil. Okay. Now the important things are knowledge. Which country is having more knowledge? And they are the king. And if I little bit that shift to that knowledge to one another is, that is data. That I'll go to the next slide. Then you can see that this data. So if you are having now more data, then you are the rich people. Now it has been already decided that more data means more rich you are. But no more now. This UAE or Iran or Kuwait, okay, they are not rich now, okay. Now, rich people are who is having a lot of data. And one example here, just one, I want to tell one more thing here, how the data is influenced, okay, basically. So if you compare the world knowledge level in 1956 here, they see that 1956, if you take that in X world knowledge level, then it took 20 years to get doubled of that world knowledge level, 2X. Okay, so X to 2X, it took 20 years. Then after 76 to 86, they took that 10 years to get the knowledge level doubled. Now, after this miracle was happened in 1986, then the personal computer came into the market, and this personal computer basically elevated the knowledge level, and it took 5 years to get the knowledge level 8x. Okay, now what is the situation? Now the data is telling that every 6 months, the knowledge level, world knowledge level is getting doubled. What is the reason behind it? That reason is data. Why the data is very important? Now you see that if you want to just transfer money from one place to another place, earlier what you used to do, telegram or that message, telegram like that, that also one type of data. But now it is fully controlled by mobile or internet banking. You just send some data and others are also collecting data, no physical money, no plastic like that. Okay, so what is happening? Now this data is basically converting. The money or everything, the wealth is now converting to data. So data is very important. That also I'll tell in the research that when we'll be a concept of research, when we'll be talking about that concept of research. So that I hope that you have understood that the knowledge economy, why that it is very important. So this is a challenge. So this NEP 2020 also they addressed this knowledge economy and other also I'll talk. Okay, then in challenge two, that is this global economy that I have already told, and rich versus poor. This one here, that in world, that 1.6 billion people are in comfortable position. You can see they are sharing their seats very comfortably in a train. But if you think about that, this is 5.4 billion people that they are traveling like that. Okay, it's not like that, but I am just comparing that how comfortable they are and how comfortable we are. Okay, so that 5.4 billion people, they are traveling in this way, and 1.6 million people are traveling in this way, like that. Okay, you don't just equate with this, the traveling purpose. We are traveling very comfortably. Don't take that. But here I want to mean the people in 5.4 billion people, that means they are poor, basically. And that 1.6 billion people, they are rich. So that rich versus poor, that gap is very much high. So that gap also to be addressed. Okay, that gap also to be addressed if we follow this NEP 2020. Okay, and global resources, that is oil, water, that is also now a challenge now. How this manage to that in global resources and global sustainability. One very important thing, this is basically our environment. Okay, well, world environment is changing very fast. World climate is changing very fast. Okay, so that global sustainability also now very important thing, that also addressed by NEP 2020. Okay, this is a very unique thing that this that also addressed by NEP 2020. I'll just highlight that what are the points basically. Now if you see in that in challenges part, then these are very important, that 4 points I have told in view of that globalization. Okay, now if you go to that in demographical change or demographics, that I told that in Asia, some part of Asia or North America, Europe, they are having the aged people more. So their priority also will be different. Okay. In developed countries, especially that in US or UK or that European that Union, that whatever, France, Germany, Sweden, whatever there, I personally that seen that their basically need is different and their desires also very different. Okay, and they are spending a lot of money for the elderly people. Okay, that healthcare, financial security, and this and national security, and they are also getting low taxes from them. So it's a problem for them. Basically, aged people are increasing too much in that developed countries. This is their challenge basically. Their priority also different. But if you come to India, that our priority is totally different. We have to give the education to our young boys and girls. Okay, so that the children are basically hungry for the education. Basically, they want that, okay, we should be educated, we will be uplifting our standard of living like that. Okay, so this aging societies is a problem, okay, for that European countries. And population mobility, another was very important that I want to ask. Okay, wherever the money is there, basically, that is also called that economic migration. I'll give one example, then you'll be understanding. Say 20-30 years back, okay, when I was also children, that time I had seen a lot of people used to migrate from Nepal to in India, and they used to basically do the security job like the Bahadur. You used to tell that in Bahadur. Okay, now you can't see that Bahadur, that is economical migration happened that time. And this population mobility now happening in different way. Now that knowledgeable people, they are basically going to abroad like that in US, they are going and they are settling US, UK, okay, and Australia, They're all developed countries, they are moving. And this is happening basically. So this population mobility is very easy now compared to the other days, okay? Now its population mobility is very easy, okay? And this population mobility is nothing but that economic migration. That means where the money is there, the people are moving that direction. That's all. Like that, okay, small thing that in our country itself, okay, if we, as we don't have much good job here in West Bengal, the young people are moving to that in Pune, Bangalore, Bombay, Delhi, Noida, like that. They are moving because good jobs are lying there. So the people are moving. This is population mobility now is happening very fast also. And the cultural diversity, if that population mobility will be there, it is obvious that the diversity of culture will be there. Okay, so what is happening? If this will be there, then all that the teenager people, now they are hungry for the education and we have to give a good education for them. And not that education only, that we have to also give good skills so they can do something. Okay, so these are, this is our target. And NEP also addressed these targets. And fourth challenge is, that is a technological change. This technological change, it is exponentiating technology. That means that whatever technology was there, I have already told that in, say, 1 year back or 6 months back, this technology are changing very fast. Even we are also basically very much in loss, basically in education sector, in all academic institutes, because that what type of equipment now we are buying after getting all this training and everything, this is almost say 3 to 4 years. Now after 3 to 4 years, these equipments are getting obsolete. Okay, because the technology is getting obsolete. So that exponential technology is happening. It's a very problematic for that developing countries and underdeveloped countries, because we can't go very fast with this. Okay, the technology. Whatever technology they are producing in the developed countries, so when you are buying, then maybe for us it is very new thing, but within 2-3 years that is getting backdated. Okay, this is one challenge. That challenge also, how to cope up with that challenge, that also can be learned from that NEP 2020. Okay, then info, bio, nano convergence. Okay, that I will add two more things here. Cognitive skill also very much, not that information technology or IoT or ICT, that besides that, this biotechnology, nanotechnology and informatics or information technology, we should also add that this cognitive skill, that means that AI, artificial learning, machine learning, that things. Okay, that is also very important, that this cognitive studies and side by side our language also, that another is a language also we have to address that things. And fourth is, it is a very interesting one, that is disruptive technologies, that I'll discuss later on, this disruptive technology later on. It's a very interesting thing. So that disruptive technologies means it is new type of technology is coming. Not that nobody can also visualize that type of technology. The new type of technology is coming. That is disruptive technology. That one example, that earlier that grocery shop was for our that grocery items we used to buy from there. Now that this Big Bazaar and that Grofers and this type of things have come. So this is totally disruptive. So within, say, 2-3 years, totally it has changed. And the people have also changed. This is disruptive. I'll tell details in this disruptive technology. This is interesting, that one. And very, very interesting thing, say, that is technology to the social change. That we are not basically caring. But now government is caring too much. Now, the government, especially in 10 months back, there was a meeting in that AICT. In that meeting, I have there, and I was also presenting there. Okay, then that meeting, what happened? That the discussion was basically that whatever the project, BTEC project, And what about the MTech project? And what about the PhD thesis will be there? That should be having some social implication. Okay, so that is there, that is coming to that NEP 2020. Okay, these things will be coming. What about the work we'll be doing in the institutes or education sector? That basically will be some social cause, basically. First, the problem will be identifying by the sector, different ministries, and that problems will be given to the institutes, and the institutes will deliver with that projects or the thesis like that. So these are the changes happening in that NEP 2020. Okay, next we'll go to that. What are the technological change has been happened? Here, you see, very interesting here, that in 1991, that teledensity was 1%. Okay. And in January 2021, that teledensity is almost 87%. So within 30 years, you see, that what are the change? 1% to that 87%. And this, you can tell that information revolution. Okay, this has been happened. From mobile sector, you see that what are the information revolution happened. And if you see the data communication sector, then if you compare in 1914, okay, that time 30 watt per, this is World War One, in 30 watt per minute, that time 30 watt per, you just remember 30 watt per minute in 1914, and 1939, that one 60 watt per minute, 1985, that is 100 watt, this is Cold War, that is 100 watt per minute, watt per minute, and Gulf War, 192,000 watt per minute, and 2010, 1.5 trillion watt per minute, that is wideband data links, and can transmit the entire British library each minute. So the data communication, that technology has been improved in so much that this one British library content, can transmit in 1 minute from one place to another place. And the interesting thing is in year 2020, it can transmit 1 lakh times of that British library data content, okay, in per minute. Okay, so this is the change. These are the changes that are happening in technological change. So that's why you see that what are the progressing this speed. Okay, now that last is key challenges 5, that is technological innovation. And I have told you that commodities are no more that innovation or knowledge, basically. Who is having more knowledge, that is more important. And analysis to synthesis, okay, that is one another important thing, that earlier we used to do more analysis than synthesis. Now that synthesis has taken the prime seat. And another is that reductionism, that means earlier what happened, that if you have something, then you see that, okay, why it is happening, what are the things that are happening. Now it is no, it is consilience. Okay, that means that, okay, you have to do that. So you get that parts and assemble it, and you can run it, drive it. That's all. So that reductionism, to know that, okay, what are the things that are happening, the time is not there. Okay, you have to learn fast, and you have to basically deliver fast. That are the things are coming now. And hierarchy to networks. And earlier, what happened, that hierarchy? That means the director, then deputy director, and these things. Now, this model is totally changed to hierarchical model, to the circular model. That means the CEO will be in middle, and CEO can contact with everybody, even to sweeper of that company. Okay, so that type of changes are happening. So this innovation, basically, is more than that simply in new technologies. That innovations are happening very fast. And in new technology, basically, it is progressing very fast. Okay, so these are the challenges, basically, so have to address by this NEP 2020. 2020. And what is the result of that technological innovations? You see that 1780 to 1840, that's steam power. Then 1980s, it is information. I'm not going to details, okay, how it has been happened. 1980, it is information technology. Then 2000 is the information intelligence system. And this is 2010, the new thing happened that this bionet, that is a chip, he'll be putting a chip. So through that chip, you can communicate with the people. That has already happened in 2010. Now this Elon Musk, that is Tesla's, living on Mars in 2030. And already that Bezos, Amazon, that CEO, he has already traveled in space. Okay, that only 13 minutes flight he took, and the same flight came back. Okay, so that has been happening. So it is giving the hope that we can travel to in Mars, okay, by 2030. Okay, and this project is leading by Elon Musk. Okay, you know that Tesla CEO, this is leading by that Elon Musk. Okay, so these are the technological that innovations are happening. So I have talked about that all this. Now we come to our point, that need of transformation in education. Okay, so in education, one thing now, that degree concept, okay, is not the ultimate. Degree concept is not ultimate. That also has been agreed by that NEP 2020. Okay, you have to produce more skills. Skills are very important compared to degree. Now, I'll give one example. In NASSCOM report, they have told whatever the engineering graduates now we are producing, that 85% of engineering graduates are useless. Okay, they are not at par. Okay, they don't know anything, basically. Only 15% they are having something, and they are basically employable. The word they are using, 15% people only employable. Okay, so that's the very poor scenario, basically. So National Education Policy 2020, they are giving more emphasis on that, okay, you should be having the skill, that I'll tell, okay, where you can grow that skill, that point when you come, that, but first you know that why you need that transformation. So that degree concept to the skill, this is very important. And R&D contest to the product contest, this is also one important thing that Dr. Sahasra Budde, that AICT chairman, he told that thing, that we are doing a lot of research. Okay, we are doing, Ramarao also told, okay, Ramarao from Delhi, he also told that we are doing a lot of research, but ultimately what is happening? It is a closed library. Nothing is happening. It is getting dust, and no people also looking that, okay, what we have done like that, R&D. So that is changing. Whatever will be there, you put a product, okay, that R&D contest to that product context. So these are the change. This is the transformation should be happening. And reductionist, that reduction means you know that more, but you have to now be integrative. That means that you have to assemble, okay, something, and you have to show that, okay, it is running, it is working like that. So these are basically reductionist to that in integrative. This is also very important, that reductionist to the integrative, that should be there. And one very important thing that also you all faculties who are attending here, they also will agree with this, that individual, we always like to work in individual. Okay, whatever I'll do, that individual. Okay, this is a very bad concept. It is not in any place in abroad. Okay, I was there in different places. I also did my PhD from University of South Australia. Basically, they hate to work individually. They hate, basically, they always want to work with team. So that team work should be there. And in India, basically, we are missing this team work. So this is also very important. Okay. Sumanto, how much time am I having? Sumanto? Are you there, Sumanto?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
How much time?
Sir, you can go for up to 4:15, sir. It's as scheduled.
Okay. No problem. Then no worries, because I am taking this little bit more time. That's why I should ask you.
No, sir. It's very interesting. So please go on.
Okay. You tell that. Okay. So what is happening that individual to team, that we want to work with individual. Okay. That is very wrong concept. That I should tell. This I also have broken in my institute here. I have a lot of projects in that multidisciplinary. I have collaboration with metallurgy department, I have collaboration with physics department, I have collaboration with computer science department. Okay. Whatever project I do, always I do with the different departments. Okay. I believe in that and I'm very much comfortable in that. Okay. So this is very much important. Okay. And this demanding a transformation by inclusion of research innovation in education policy. Okay. This should be in education policy. And I have seen that in NEP 2020, this has been addressed basically. That skill, product concept and integrative and team concept. Okay. They have given a lot of emphasis in that NEP 2020. Okay. So I hope that, okay, you have understood that, okay, why we need that this transformation in education. Okay. Now we'll go to this is demanding the change in national education policy. Okay. These are the these are the point what I thought, okay, these are the very important points that is basically demanding the change in national education policy. All right. Now I'll discuss, okay, what is there in NEP 2020. Okay. This is one is that universalization of education, that is right of children to free and compulsory education, that all you know, okay. Another change has been happened, 5+3+3+4, okay. That earlier this 10+2 system to divide it in 5, like basically 5+3+3+4. And very important thing, they have given more emphasis on sports, arts, commerce, science, okay, at the same level, okay. That will be the same level, and that will be also giving some vocational subjects in that. And computer skills coding, from class 6 onward, they will be giving. One is that internship, not only that you will be going for the coding, that you have to also prove with some summer internship or winter internship, you go there and do something, okay. By hands-on something you do, okay. And this meal is energy field breakfast. But another is that exam system, that school examination in grades 3, 5, and 8, and that should be rigorous, okay. Not like that, it will be taken by that appropriate authority. So that will be conducting earlier that in our childhood we have seen, we have a Bitti examination scholarship. We used to tell in Bengali, that is Bitti, Parikha, Bitti exam. But that was very good in our time. No, we basically cherish that exam. And that's a very good step that time it was there. Okay. But I don't know that why this system has ebbed up now that no more. But 3, 5, and 8, that will be there. And in 10 and 12 exams to be easier, that I don't know that why they have told that easier. It may be easier, it may be tough, but they have given that easier, but I should write that, okay, that should be made easier. And exam will be twice, okay. 10 and 12 exam will be twice and best of 2, I think they will be taking. And more important thing is critical thinking should be taking very important seat basically. And all study will be holistic. Okay, that overall everything you have to study. And it should be inquiry based. And it has to be that discovery based and discussion based. That discussion based, why they were given? Because it will be building up the team capability basically. It will be with team. So that are the things that included in NEP 2020. And in teachers' capability also, there will be continuous some education will be for that in teachers. Continuous faculty development program will be there, and it will be conducted by different organizations. Here they have given that NCFT, like that this framework will be there, and NCERT will be there. But this teacher capability is also every time it will be trying to improve by that this national education policy. And instruction in mother tongue will be in regional language, and flexibility in higher education, that portable credits. I'm not going to the details, but because this is in NEP 2020, so I want to give some salient points in that in NEP 2020. All you know, basically. And as I have already discussed, that is multidisciplinary education of global standards in the country. Okay. And last point, that one is this National Research Foundation. That is very important thing. I want to talk with this National Research Foundation. So presently, we have different type of this funding organization. One is that Department of Science and Technology. One is that in AICT. One is that in MHRD. Okay, one is DRDO. Okay, there are different type of organizations who are funding for the research. Now, what the government is planning, now one that funding will be there, that is called National Research Foundation. Okay, and what was the problem in that different type of that funding organization? Because one fellow has given one project in, say, DST. Okay, now that DST has not been approved, that project, so he had given to that in AICT. So AICT has been approved. Okay, like that, what happened? This type of things are happening, which is not basically good. Okay, so this type of duplicity and some corruption, then not accountable, like that, these things will be now no more. So this research foundation, now they are trying to get rid of all these anomalies, basically, and the things which are not good for that research purpose. So this will be one that National Research Foundation. Okay, another is that industry aligned higher education for research and innovation. So this is very, very important. Okay, I if you compare with that in this any developed countries, what happens that if you want to take one PhD student, say one faculty wants to take one PhD student, so first thing they will see, okay, do you have any project which is aligned with any industry or not? Okay, if you don't have project, then you will be not allowed to take one research fellow. Okay, so that is their criteria. Okay, when I also joined, then my first that professor was, didn't have that project. Then second, he was having the project, so he was guiding me, basically. So like that. So this, you have to be a project, industry aligned project, then only you are allowed to take one research student. So these are the things to be implemented in near future in India. Okay, so next we'll go to that in research problems in academic in India. What happens now here is a library. Now 70 to 100% of problems originate in the laboratory and end up in the laboratory. In our research now, what happens now, 70 to 100% problems originate in the laboratory and end up in laboratory. We don't have any that clue that, okay, how it can be basically useful for the society or how it can be useful for the country, basically. So what will be happening now? Now what is happening now? We have to see first the societal problems, then that social science area become important. Then these societal problems you have to identify. Then you have to identify R&D projects, tech parks, COEs, all these you identify, and for these DRDOs and this ISRO, DAE, whatever the problems they are having, all the problems will be giving to the educational institute, and this will be just solving by the educational institute through some BTEC projects, MTEC projects, or some thesis. Okay, now this is the national education policy. Now, what is the role of that academics now in our country through this national education policy? Okay, and now I'll talk about the concept of research with with example, basically, I'll give the data information knowledge triangle. How one student, when he'll be joining, then how he can that do a project, basically. And what should be the project as per the national education policy? So first of all, they should know that what is the problem. Okay, he has to identify the problem. So how he can identify the problem? He can identify the problem through the data. That means he will take the literature survey, he will do the literature survey, he will do the other things, okay, why it is happening, what are the methodologies the people have that followed, and that all the things he has to see. So that data he has to collect. Okay, from data, then data is basically, in terms of in computer, the data is basically facts and figures which that relay something specific. Okay, so here, in research point of view, the data you'll be collecting, okay, what are the people have done in this field and what are the things we can do, how we can do, that all literature survey you'll be collecting through the data. From the data, you'll be collecting the information. That means you'll be filtering all the data and the gist of this data is what direction we can work, you'll be making on information. So data will be bulk in the base level of the triangle, then it will go to that information. So this way research will be also done. The data will be there in the base level. That information will be collected. And ultimately that knowledge will be building up in this top end of the triangle. And this will be the thesis of your work. So that data will be in the base level and middle level will be the information. In that all work will be doing in the research. Okay, what are the methodologies will be there? What are the things you have to do? What are the results are to be filtered and what are the results are to be discarded? That all you see that information, then particularly you reach to that your knowledge totally, then this will be the thesis. So this data, then information and knowledge, very similarity with this data, information, knowledge triangle with that research concept. So I have put here. So I have, I used to give one example here. Say, I think in that, 6 to 7 years back, there was a huge that cloud burst in Uttarakhand. That time, that Rishikesh, Haridwar, and everything was flooding basically. Okay, so that time, what was data? I used to give the example. Data are different places. What happened in that Uttarakhand that are collected by the reporter here. Then after that, some information are very important, like that this. The road were broken and the truck was also falling down. These are the information, okay. And these lot of things are happening here. This is the information. Then ultimately the knowledge is that in Shivo Bhava, that's there. The knowledge is in the triangle. So this knowledge is there. So in research also, the research triangle also, data, information, knowledge, that will build up. So what will happen? First, if some student will come to you for the research, or for students also, I'm telling that, okay, if you want to do the research, first you have to explore that what are the things that will happen. Okay, you collect the data, then from data you filter, then make that information from there, okay, what you will do, and do your work for 2-3 years, then see, accumulate all the data, and you create the knowledge from there, okay, and you go to there and write a thesis. So this will be the ultimate, the writing a thesis, and this is the knowledge. So that knowledge level will be there. I hope that you have understood that what do you mean by the research. But in national education policy perspective, these data will be for social implication or that this country's development, some any product we have to produce. Okay. Not that you will be doing a lot of simulations. Okay. I have also seen in our institute, I don't want to name the department. Okay. A lot of departments they are doing. But not only our institute, in IITs also have seen, ISCs also seen, lot of simulations job they are doing. Okay, and they are publishing papers also. Lot of papers they are publishing. No use for that. One paper you do, okay, one paper you do per year. Basically for me, I do 2 or 3 papers, okay, per year. All experimental and that is having some product. Okay, so that simulation doesn't basically have any meaning now. Okay, that I'm telling. So I have seen also, they are also presenting the data in dollar, US dollar. Okay, so some profit will be happening. So in electrical, I am telling, okay, some simulation they are doing, okay, this tariff will be increasing in the data level. What is the use of that? Okay, data. So that this is giving by that in dollar. So what is the use of that? So I request all of you, okay, or students, basically even faculties also, faculty members also, please try to identify the problem, the social problem. Then you start your work. Maybe that this work is very small, but it will be useful for the country. Okay, now these are the five pillars. Now, these are the five pillars, that is information technology. Why that information technology is very important? You see that example, Saudi Arabia. Okay, crude oil exports 2019, that is US dollar. Here I am using US dollar, okay, because this slide is US dollar, because it is foreign thing. 133.6 billion, okay, that is Saudi Arabia exports oil 2019. India IT exports in 137 billion, okay, that 133.6, and IT export is, so how important this information technology, you can identify from here, okay, US dollar 137. Then biotechnology, that is also very much in global aspect. If you see, that largest provider of generic drugs globally, 50% global vaccines from India, okay, and 40% of generic demand in the US and 25% of these medicines in UK. From our India it is going, okay. And nanotechnology, we are ranked third in the world. So we are having the potential. My meaning is that we are having the potential, only we have to basically give a jerk, okay, then it will run. And India ranked fifth in AI and ML, and that is cognitive technology, and quantum, that is a strong tradition for basic research. That is also very much, it is also equally important. Not only that, only you make that product, but this strong traditional basic research also very much important, that is quantum technology. Okay, this is very much important. Don't forget with this information technology. A lot of jobs are there in information technology, but this is also equally important, that otherwise 10, 25 years after, there will be a vacuum. Okay, now we'll go to that in how we can solve this problem. Okay, that industry aligned higher education for research innovation. This model I have made when I met a Sonodyne CEO. Okay, he came to my institute and we are doing a project with them. So this model I made, that what is the model basically you have to do, and this is similar to that in national education policy. Okay, this is identify the problem, then study the problem from the viable solution, if any. These are the steps basically, and conceptual idea, draft solution, then measure parameters, conduct field test. What basically that in GIST, I'll tell, time is not permitting basically for, Sumanto has told me 4:15. Okay, so I have to finish it with this. Okay, so this, all this is bridge with that industry basically, and what the industry's role, they will design the product and build the market ready units, and feedback from mechanism from the industries, and suggestion from the further development. This will be doing by the industries, and we'll be doing the institutes. Okay, these are the that role basically, institutes role will be there, and students will be having the chance to interact with the industry. Okay, these are the disruptive changes that are not going to details. So earlier that mainframe computer to mobile, it has come. So who are the disruptor is personal computer, and disruptor is mainframe mini computers. Okay. And retail medicine clinics to traditional doctor's offices to retail medicine clinics. So then 4-year colleges to community college, like that. These are the disruption has been happened. Okay. And disruption in grocery, you can see that this market to the gophers, okay, this big bazaar to that gophers, now it has come. And for hotel services, YO is the disruptor, okay, these are disruptors. And books, it is Kindle, the digital books, no more that this is now famous. And this eating purpose, that is Food Panda and Zomato. Okay, these are the disruptions that have happened. Okay, now in media, what are the disruptions? TV and this, the computer, that is going to happen, WhatsApp, chat, Facebook, okay, so many things. So disruption in the media, how it has happened. Okay, so that I have shown you. Now, this, don't be afraid of change. It is this quotation I have taken, okay, from Facebook. Don't be afraid of change. It is leading to a new beginning. Okay, so don't be afraid. Okay, it will be new beginning. Now I'll come. So I think that I have finished in that NEP 2020, that research and innovation. But ranking part is left. Okay, so I'll just highlight that ranking part now. Okay, what is the institutes runs now, but does well, but uncertainty. Now what is happening? We have vague accountability. We don't have much accountability, no transparency, and status not known, because we are not having that ERP, okay, that entrepreneurship, the resource solution that is not there. ERP solution is not there. So what you have to do basically, that you have to monitoring. You have to do the monitoring, or you have to give some rank or rewards. Otherwise, nothing will happen. That also ministry has been that understood. That's why all that NIRF has come. National Institute is that framework has been come. Okay, so ranking for framework, National Institutional Ranking for Framework has been come. So what will be happening now? Now it is there. You see that the data are going from that top, from schools and higher education institutes, then it is going to the ministries. And after that, there are no that tracing. Okay, nothing is happening. Okay, now slowly that implementing that ranking at these things, what is happening now? Now this has been changed basically. So now the situation is they are trying to do that. It is not 100% now, maybe 10%, 20%. They have made that Council of Education, Research and Innovation. They are managing research, innovation, education, new era. How you can manage? This is with through rank. This is monitoring. So all these data will be going to that ministries or PMOs if it will be there. And one Council of Research Education, that is research funding, NRF is there. Then NCRT is there. All will be going there. And from there, that feedback will be coming. Okay, what is happening like that? So these are the changes through this assessment, evaluation, rewards, incentives, that monitoring through ranking schools. What will be happening? Result. Result is that it should be accountable. Okay, it should be accountable. It should be transparent, and it should be instantaneous status. Okay, if that will be happening, then we can get, we will be accountable. Then we will be transparent, and this will be getting that instantaneous status. Okay. This is basically required in NEP, and they have made it that ranking and National Institutional Ranking Framework. They have made NIRF, and in NIT Durgapur now we are having rank of 47. We are having 47. So if it will be within 100, then we will be getting good that funding. Otherwise, we will not get. Okay. So in conclusion, okay, I will conclude with this. That innovate and implement. Okay, dear students, that always try to innovate something and implement and collaborate and compete. That is very important. You collaborate and compete with this, not only with us, with international level also you compete. Okay, then thank you very much. So it's not the end, it's the beginning. Then if any question you can ask. Okay, if any question, dear students or any faculty members, please ask any question. Thank you very much. Yes.
Thank you, sir, for this wonderful presentation. So I'd like to ask the participants. So please ask our resource persons any questions as he has requested. So if you have any questions, please ask.
If you have any question, then I'll be very happy to answer you. Okay, I understand nothing hard. Okay, please, because virtual mode. Okay, I can't see you. If it is offline mode, then at least I can see your faces and make out that you understand or not. Please, how many that 25, 26? Okay, at least 4 or 5 people should ask some questions. Have you understood anything or not? Sukanna, I can see Sukanna. Yes.
Sukanna.
Or you?
Or anybody?
Anybody, okay. Somendra, Sukanna, Gautam, Biplab. or they have put on their
sorry sir, but I am in a bus so I can't speak.
Yes, go down.
Sir, I'm in a bus, sir. I'm in a bus.
Oh, you have already took the bus. Okay, good. Okay, anything?
Okay, sir. If you permit me, I would like to ask you a question, sir.
Yes. If, why not?
As you have many PhD students under your guidance, so how do you guide them to make a product or do PhD in a team?
Yeah, that present situation to make a product is very difficult, basically. So what we are doing, we are going to the prototype level. Already 2-3 prototype level we have made in our lab. Our lab is very big lab, and it is one of the best lab in India, basically. It's ICT enabled and IoT enabled high voltage laboratory facilities. So presently that we are working with electric vehicles, basically the insulation management system of electric vehicles. So what we do basically in pandemic situation itself, last year in December, one PhD student have joined, and I have given some tasks to him that you try to collaborate with some industries as well as some foreign universities, and he has already succeeded with some one company that is Maruti that making that another is from UK university. So we are talking with that. So I have given the task, and we are doing very well with that.
Sir, I have one question. Shukalpa. Acha, that as because the, our institute are private institute, so from here research oriented research is very difficult to get some grant from any AICT or the other DST. So do you have any suggestion that what to do for this, that to make some grant from that portions to increase our research work, because we don't
that
have
is very good. Yeah, that is very pertinent question. What happened earlier that say 4-5 years back, to get a project fund was very easy for us also. Now it is very difficult. Now to get a project that fund, we have to apply different places, but a lot of formalities are there. And take you one umbrella was there that we are just asking for the fund. But now the in under this NEP 2020 that national that research fund NRF will be there, and in that they have elaborately discussed in the meeting that this type of fund also will be distributed to the private institute also if they are doing well. If they are being avoided, if they are doing well. So you can also collaborate with some private institutes, for that project funding. So you can collaborate with some institute also here in your field. Then you can get a lot of money in social sector. Social sector, lot of
And actually, as an engineering institute, basic science is very much neglected. That for the chemistry, if we want to do something, or for physics, that we have to collaborate with some engineering department separately. No,
that's not true in the case. Say that our physics departments are doing very well. Our physics department, especially, they are doing real. They are bringing a lot of projects. They are getting the projects in chemistry department. Also, they are doing very much, but physics department is doing very well.
Okay.
Not only neglected that. That physics department now doing very well. They are having good projects now. Even bioscience. Then biotechnology. Not that this total engineering. They are having. A lot of projects.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for your nice presentation.
Any other questions from your end, sir? Sorry, the participants.
Dr. Ghosh, Dr. Piyush, Piyush, any question? Dr. Piyush Kanti Ghosh.
No, sir, till now,
I'm not. I don't know. Okay. I'm doing the right thing or not, that I don't know.
Exactly, sir. You're okay. Doing the right thing, definitely, sir.
Okay. Anything in your mind? No students. No, I am very much hearted. No, that no students. Not a single question from students.
Okay, sir. Then we have come to the wind-up session, sir. So I would like to thank our participants to join in the webinar. And so before ending this session, I would like to show the appreciation certificate for our keynote speaker. Let me present screen, sir, first. So is it visible to you, sir?
Yeah, this is all right.
Yes, sir. So this is the appreciation certificate from our end, from all the group, BC Roy Polytechnic College, for your wonderful presentation over here. And now I would like to call up our developer and HOD, Mr. Pikanti Ghosh, to wind up and end the session. What to you, sir? Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Sumanth, the coordinator of today's for giving me the opportunity to present a vote of thanks. First of all, very good afternoon, everyone. I am Piyush Kanti Ghosh, nodal officer of the theme-based webinar series on completion of one of the transformative reforms under new education policy, NEP 2020, proposed by the Ministry of Education, Government of India. On behalf of Dr. BC Roy Polytechnic, I am here to present the vote of thanks for today's webinar. I'd like to thank our webinar speaker, Professor Nirmal Kumar Roy Sir, for enlightening us with his knowledge. I'm pretty sure that precious knowledge that Sir gave us, the valuable thoughts that Sir shared with us, will definitely help us in our near future. Once again, I'd like to thank our Professor Nirmal Kumar Roy Sir for giving us your valuable time from your busy schedule. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
I would also most welcome, sir, and welcome to Dr. BC Roy Polytechnic again.
So you can punish. I'm also. Okay, I'm leaving then.
Okay.
Shukalpa,
yes,
thanks.
Okay, sir.
Thanks, Sumanta. Thanks. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
And all the students.